and welcome to this different episode of Plus Quinma. I'm your host, Quinma, and let's get this started. So, normally I do Let's Plays on this channel, and this Plus Quinma slot is used for the PC version of My Sims, as well as the Pokemon X tag lock. But today, I'm doing something very different. I'm going to talk about The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, coming out March 2017. Specifically, I'm going to talk about timeline theories for this game that I have seen. I'll even add in my own. So, I'm going to explain the defense for each of these time placements, as well as my opinion on how probable these theories I have seen online are. Let's start with the ones that I think are impossible.
After Skyward Sword!
Now, I have seen a lot of people guessing that this game is a sequel to Skyward Sword, but I think that is rather impossible. The biggest defense I have seen is that the art style is the same and that there's technology similar to Skyward Sword. But I have to remember, not including the manga in Hyrule Historia, Skyward Sword is the first story in the Legend of Zelda lore, hence, said technology could appear anywhere. In theory. The reason why I think it is impossible is because of the state of the world. Look at the Master Sword in the Temple of Time. They're both totally rusted and destroyed. There's no way that those things could be in such disarray yet appear pristine and perfect a few centuries later in Ocarina of Time. I mean, sure, you can argue that they were restored at some point, but I think it's highly unlikely.
After Majora's Mask, but before Twilight Princess.
The defense for this one is flimsy at best. I've seen online people arguing that it must take place in the child timeline due to the architecture of the bridges in Breath of the Wild. This is because they are similar to the ones in Twilight Princess. But that's just architecture. Said bridges could have been built in any timeline. Besides that, Twilight Princess takes place 100 years after Majora's Mask, and Breath of the Wild takes place 100 years after some game, we just don't know what it is yet. So if it took place 100 years after Majora's Mask, then wouldn't Breath of the Wild have to retcon Twilight Princess in order to fit there? More than that even, the Korok proved that this cannot take place in the child timeline. Now, I know I've seen people saying that it's possible because the Kokiri did not evolve into the Korok and the Korok is just their natural form. But if I remember Wind Waker correctly, they straightly state that the Korok are descendants of the Kokiri and they evolved to adapt to the rising sea levels in the adult timeline. But I will not state that it can only be in the adult timeline, and I'll get to that later.
After Link's Awakening!
The last theory that I believe is impossible is after Link's Awakening and before A Link Between Worlds. The only defense I've seen for this is that in Breath of the Wild, when Link wakes up, he has to rise again. Again being the key word here. The Link from A Link to the Past is the Link that has starred in the most games, being that he was also in Oracle of Seasons, Oracle of Ages, and Link's Awakening. But just like the theory that the game takes place 100 years after Majora's Mask, this theory runs into the same problem, because A Link Between Worlds takes place 100 years after Link's Awakening. Hence, just like the previous one, A Link Between Worlds, as well as Triforce Heroes, would need to be deemed non-canon for this game to fit there. Okay, so next, let's move on to the ones that I personally believe are far-fetched and unlikely, but still possible.
After Ocarina of Time, but before Wind Waker!
Due to the presence of the Korok, the adult timeline certainly has a strong chance of being a possible placement. The main argument I have seen for this one involves words from Skyward Sword and the prologue of Wind Waker. As most know, the world of the adult timeline was drowned in order to stop Ganon when he returned, and there is no hero to stop him. However, the argument is that it was stated in Skyward Sword that every time Demise's evil rises, Hylia's chosen hero will be there to stop him. Yet, there is no hero to stop him in the Wind Waker prologue. Hence, it has been argued that there was a hero, but no one remembers him because he lost. There is also no stated time increment from between Ocarina of Time and Wind Waker. However, because of the state of the world, I have to say that the theory is unlikely. But I don't want to rule it out purely because of the presence of the Korok.
After Adventure of Link!
This is actually my theory, and I know it's unlikely. This is actually purely based on the text from Hyrule Historia about the end of the downfall timeline. Quote, did generations pass full of peace and the light of prosperity? Or did the curtain rise on an age of darkness when people quarreled and searched for power? The future of this timeline has yet to be unraveled. End quote. So, yeah, there's plenty of room here. Plus, it would be cool to play as the Link from the original Legend of Zelda, but I know it's unlikely.
Convergence theory!
Now, this is a theory I didn't even know existed until I was writing the script for this thing. It goes that Breath of the Wild takes place after all three timelines, so being after Adventure of Link, Spirit Tracks, and Four Swords Adventures. This theory says that because that there are elements of all the timelines, that they once more converged into one. This makes things way more confusing than it has to be. The line that Link must wake again after 100 years is what makes this highly unlikely to ever happen. Because then, which Link are we? Are we the one from the original Legend of Zelda? The one from Spirit Tracks? Or the one from Four Swords Adventures? Sure, it can be argued that this is an entirely different Link in that he went through a different journey 100 years ago that simply isn't seen. Then that argument turns to the amiibo, saying that the Wolf Link amiibo, Toon Link amiibo, 8-Bit Link amiibo, and Ocarina of Time amiibo are all reps for the other timelines that are all converged. But if this is at the end of all the timelines, then why is Ocarina of Time Link here? He was already from a unified timeline. Plus, there's also the Toon Zelda amiibo uncounted for. And we don't even know if these four amiibo function in Breath of the Wild the same way as Wolf Link does. After all, there are amiibo from the Breath of the Wild Link coming out too. If Nintendo goes back on what they said about Hyrule Warriors being non-canon, then this theory is entirely possible. If this is the case, then the convergence happened in Hyrule Warriors, and the Link waking up is the main Link from Hyrule Warriors. That's why I can't rule this as impossible. But I still feel it's unlikely. Though, if Nintendo did go this route, it'd be a good marketing tactic, as this game is for the 30th anniversary of Legend of Zelda. Okay, now for the two theories that I think are entirely possible and the most likely.
After Spirit Tracks!
While I may be biased in saying that I think this one I found is possible because the adult timeline has my favorite games in it, please just hear me out. So, the presence of the Korok, as I said, makes a huge argument for the adult timeline. Plus, the state of the world can be explained by the receding sea, a goal that the Korok and Great Deku Tree strive to do by planting seeds, also serving as a side quest for Link in Wind Waker. Just saying. So, assuming that this is the case, then it would mean that a number of people who lived on the island, the ones that didn't go with Link and Tetra to found New Hyrule, have moved back down onto land. Maybe even some of the residents of New Hyrule went to go live in Old Hyrule. Plus, the mountains are really, really tall. Granted, we haven't seen the peaks of all these mountains, but we have to remember that when the Great Flood happened, that the people went to tall mountains to create new homes, thus creating these islands. So geographically, it works. That's why I think this placement in the timeline makes sense and is possible.
After Ocarina of Time, but before Link to the Past!
This is the only other theory I've found that makes complete sense. Now, Game Explain covers this one in their 2-hour analysis video better than I can do here, but if you don't have time for Game Explain the movie, then you have my summary. Now, earlier in this video, I said I would address why the Korok could have evolved from the Kokiri in other timelines. Well, I was talking about this one specifically. Since Ganon's darkness overtook the land in a calamity, one can assume that said darkness caused the Kokiri to evolve into the Korok. Next, as this is in the middle of a timeline, we have to make sure that there is more than 100 years between games. And there is! No time increment is stated for between Ocarina of Time and Link to the Past. Now, just like how the Wind Waker prologue theory says that Link was defeated but survived and put in stasis, despite that Link was defeated in Ocarina of Time, he could have survived and be put in stasis. So there is strong grounding for this theory to be possible. Furthermore, from a marketing perspective, the Fallen Hero timeline has been getting a lot of love as late, with both A Link Between Worlds and Triforce Heroes taking place in that timeline. So it wouldn't surprise me at all if another game in recent memory was placed there. Okay, well, that was all of the Breath of the Wild timeline theories I have found. So what do you think of my analysis on each one? Do you think I'm onto something, or that I'm crazy and one of the ones I deemed impossible is canon? Is there another theory I missed? Let me know! Maybe I'll even do a follow-up to this video on any new theories and your ideas, or do something similar in the future. Thank you for watching! Your regular Plus Quinma schedule will resume on Monday.